This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a powerful ring of fire. I provided a link to a custom set of fire sparks, as well as a link to this dark background, which is in my video's description or project files. Feel free to use another dark background if you like. If you do use another background, make its resolution 72 pixels per inch to ensure that the setting amounts I'll be using in this tutorial will give you similar results as mine. To check its resolution, go to Image and Image Size. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Open the Ellipse tool and at the top, select Path. Drag the tool out until the circular path is approximately this size. To reposition it, open the Path Selection tool and drag it. To resize it, go to a corner and press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it out or in. Go to Filter, Render, and Flame. Before we build our flames, I suggest you pause the video to copy my settings. However, I encourage you to play with all of them to see how they affect the flames. There are two tabs in the flame window, Basic and Advanced. Under Basic, we can choose the type of flame. I'm using multiple flames one direction. I checked Randomize Length and Adjust Interval for loops. We can customize the colors of our flames by checking the box next to Use Custom Color for Flames. When the color box appears, click it to customize its colors. To ensure the highest quality, choose Fine. This does take longer to render, but the detail is better. Under Advanced, again, pause the video to copy these settings. We'll reposition it just above the floor. To do this, open your Move tool and simply drag the flames. To hide the path, press Ctrl or Command H. Double-click the flame thumbnail to open its layer style window. Click Outer Glow and the color box. In the hexadecimal field, type in FF9706. Change the blend mode to overlay and pause the video to copy these settings. We'll make two copies of the flames by pressing Ctrl or Command J twice. Change the blend mode of the top flame to overlay. Double-click Outer Glow of the bottom flame to open it in the Layer Style window. Change its blend mode to Color Dodge. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 5 pixels. To save space in the Layers panel, let's place all the flame layers into a folder. Shift-click the top layer to make all the flame layers active. Press Ctrl or Command G. I'll name it Ring of Fire. Make a new layer. In this layer, we'll add sparks, but before we do, let's place it into a folder as well. I'll name it Sparks. Make the layer active and open your brush tool. After you install the custom brush set I provided, open the brush picker and scroll to the bottom of your list of brushes. Open the Fire Sparks brush folder and click Fire Sparks 01. Make it size 800 pixels. Its opacity and flow are both 100%. Click the foreground color and click on a light yellow color of the flames to pick up its color. If you want to use the exact color I'm using, type in FFFC71. Click over the flames once and reduce its size by pressing the left bracket key on your keyboard until the size is 500 pixels. Click over various areas of the ring and feel free to adjust the brush's size. Double-click the layer to open its layer style window. Click Outer Glow and the color box. Pick a bright red color. Change the blend mode to normal and the size to 10 pixels. Press Ctrl or Command J to make a copy of the Sparks layer. Make the original Sparks layer active and go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 2 pixels. Lastly, we'll mask out some of the sparks in the center of the ring. But first, let's collapse the folder to save some space in the Layers panel. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to the folder. Open the Brush Picker and pick a soft, round brush. Reduce the size of your brush by pressing the left bracket key on your keyboard and brush below the top of the ring to mask out the sparks directly under the ring. At the top, reduce the brush's opacity and brush over the center of the ring. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.